Hey friends, in this video, let me demonstrate how I can use AWS Lambda to send and receive SQS messages. Let's say you have some heavy process on the main thread and you want to push it away, so you can push it to an SQS queue and then receive it in a worker to consume it and do the heavy lifting. Let's create a queue that delegates creating tasks. Standard queue, we call it my task queue, and we delay the delivery of messages by 30 seconds. And we have the visibility 60 seconds. And then we disable encryption. We use standards here. And we create the queue. Let's create a new Lambda function to send the tasks to be created. So we create a new function. We use a blueprint, hello world, Node.js, my Lambda task sender, create a new role with basic Lambda permissions, and create. The function is ready. Now we need to tweak it a bit. So we start by importing SQS from client SQS. This is provided by AWS. Then we create new SQS, and then we need the query URL from the SQS queue. We navigate into SQS and find our queue, and here we can find the URL, and this is what we need here. Let's play with this function a bit. So we're just gonna return here the event, and let's deploy that. And then we're gonna test it out. So we're gonna send here description, the new task, and target date. And we test it out, and it's working. Now we can extend our function a bit. So we define a task here, just some ID, the description, the target date, the is complete. And let's just try returning that here, deploy it, and see if it's working. Looks good. Let's now actually send the task over to SQS. So we do that here. Send message, the message body is stringified task, and then the query URL. Let's now deploy it and try it out. Probably fails because of permissions. Yes, we're missing to set up the permissions. In the error message, we can find the information, we can find the ARN of the queue, and we can see here we're missing the send message permission. So let's navigate to configuration, permissions. Here we can find our role. We navigate over to that, and we're gonna add an inline policy for SQS. I'm gonna allow here send message, and we're gonna specify here the SQS queue, and next we call it my SQS role. Create. Let's now try the Lambda again. So we go into here, into test, and press test. It's working. We then have to wait 30 seconds to see if the message is available in the queue. So we go into the queue, send and receive messages, and poll for messages. It's here. Let's now create the Lambda receiver that's gonna take the messages and create them actually. So we create a new function. Use a blueprint. There is a one here called SQS, and we call it my Lambda task receiver. Create a new role. We call it my Lambda receiver role, and we remove the trigger and we create a function. I prefer this interface to add the trigger. So now I get here, select SQS and our queue, and just use the defaults here and add. It's now been enabled, so let's go ahead, and if you look at the code here, you can see it's taking the records and just console logging them. So now we should see something in our logs. So we go here into CloudWatch and the log stream here, and here we can see the task. Because we consumed the event, our queue should now be empty. Let's verify that. So we go over to SQS and we pull for messages, and it's empty. Let's extend the receiver a bit and store records in Dynamodb. So first we import the relevant libraries, so Dynamodb and Dynamodb document, and then we create this Dynamo object here. And here in, we need to call Dynamo.put, but we need a task object, so let's create that here. And then we put a new object here. That's item, that's the task, and table name is my tasks. And then we console log task created. And we deploy the function. Let's now go into Dynamo and create a table. Create a table, my tasks, and the partition key is ID. And we create it. The table has now been created. Let's now get into it. Additional information. And here is the IRN. Let's copy that. Let's now navigate into the receiver and into permissions and find the role. Let's navigate into that. So we need to update some policies. So we create an inline policy and set it here, DynamoDB. And we need to be able to put an item. And let's do that. And let's specify the ARN we copied and create an ARN. And we just put some name here and create policy. Let's now try everything again, see if we can send a message, receive it, and create it in the table. So we go into the sender, and we create a new event here, and we say description and target date, some values there, and we test it out. Now we just have to wait. We were able to send it, but does it work out? Looking at our logs, there seems to be a slight snafu in the application. So type mismatch, expecting string, but actual number. For the ID. So if we go back to our sender, and we can see here we're sending date now here as a number, but let's change that to string and deploy it. And we try it again. So test. Seems this did the trick. Looking at the logs in the receiver, we can see here it did create a task here. And looking at DynamoDB, we can go here and we can see get live item count. And there are actually three items in there because I tried this a few times. That's it for this video. I hope you liked it. I'll see you in the next one.